Here, welcome today to a video that's all about the foods that will help lower your creatinine levels naturally. Natural diuretics are key for a better health. They don't just reduce hypertension, serum potassium levels, and get you rid of excess sugar and sodium. They will directly help you lower your creatinine levels. How, you ask? You see, when the kidneys aren't doing their job at 100%, fluid retention or the accumulation of excess fluids and scores in the body may cause serious problems. Swollen ankles and feet, toxin accumulation and shortness of breath, just to name a few. And all that extra water is also linked to worsened hypertension, which can definitely make CKD progress faster. This is why today we are going to see what foods, beverages, and vitamins can really help with water retention. Are you ready to detoxify your body naturally? Let's start! Many people believe that asparagus is the number one food when it comes to natural diuretics. But is it really? Let's take a look at what foods are even better in terms of detoxifying the kidneys naturally. Starting with pineapple. Pineapple is a great source of healthy carbs, low enough on the glycemic index to be part, in moderation, even of the diet of people with diabetes, especially if you eat it, in moderation, at the same time as healthy fat and fiber. And pineapple is more than a tasty snack. It has some serious health benefits. First of all, it's a natural diuretic, like all the foods we will see today. And pineapple also has anti-inflammatory and anti-clotting properties, great for people with CKD and diabetes. All these amazing properties are due to an enzyme called bromelain. Pineapple is the only major dietary source of this incredible nutrient. I've recommended supplementing bromelain in the past because bromelain is incredibly effective against uric acid. Having too much uric acid is very common in people with kidney disease, and it's the cause of gout, a painful condition, and it also causes kidney damage. Bromelain does also help with digestion and with inflammation, as I was saying. What not many people know is that the highest concentration of bromelain is in the center of the fruit, the part that most discard. In the center of the fruit is also the part with the less amount of sugar. Stop discarding it and make pineapple even healthier. Up next, another great way of fighting water retention and detoxing your kidneys. Lemon water. A lot of people love to drink lemon water in the morning to flush out toxins and to help bowel movement. And there are reasons why people with kidney problems will benefit from lemon water, says science. First of all, if you drink a glass of lemon water first thing in the morning, you'll be one glass closer to your goal of 8 glasses of water per day. Great to help your kidneys do their job. Second, lemon water is alkaline, great to protect the kidneys. And also, lemon water contains a sufficient amount of vitamin C, and this is very important. You see, this vitamin C has diuretic properties, especially powerful when combined with sufficient water. This will help the kidneys remove more sodium and water from the body. So if you love starting your day with a refreshing glass of lemon water, here's another reason to continue this healthy habit. Science supports its benefits. Up next, a superfood with some of the most incredible kidney protecting benefits. Garlic. Oh yes, garlic is even more amazing than you thought. Garlic is mostly known and loved for its anti-hypertensive properties. Well, while this benefit is completely supported by science, garlic also has several other properties. It can be used to control blood sugar levels, and it may also help with cholesterol. Today, science tells us that garlic also has another incredible property. Garlic is also a diuretic. So, just like the other foods of today's video, it will help you with swelling and water retention. And by the way, garlic needs to be prepared in a special way to be truly helpful. This is why I've made a full video about it. It's up here and also down in description. Okay, what can be even better? Well, one of the best foods out there when it comes to health benefits is ginger. Ginger is not just one of the most powerful anti-inflammatory foods out there. Ginger is also amazing at reducing water retention. It's a potent diuretic that naturally stimulates urine production. And ginger also comes with several other properties. It improves circulation by acting as a vasodilator, which means it widens the blood vessels and lowers blood pressure. This can also help with water retention and edema. Ginger is also known as a heavy metal chelator, meaning that it binds to and removes heavy metals, especially cadmium, which is considered one of the worst risks for kidney patients. Now, I consider ginger as effective as garlic, or maybe even better, for one reason. You don't need to prepare it in any special ways at all to get the benefits. Just add it to your soups and rice dishes, or enjoy it in a tea. And when it comes to foods with diuretic properties, we can't forget celery. This vegetable has long been recognized as a natural diuretic, helping to increase urine production and decrease water retention. And also, beets. Beets are a natural diuretic that can help reduce water retention and hypertension. And also, cherries. These fruits and their stems can act as diuretics and help lower pressure and inflammation. Also, cucumbers. These vegetables are rich in vitamin C, K, B, copper, magnesium, and manganese, which can help regulate fluid balance and hypertension. And also, asparagus. This tasty veggie contains asparagin, an amino acid that acts as a natural diuretic and increases urine production. And also, parsley. Parsley is a spice with powerful diuretic properties. It has been used in traditional medicine to help increase urine production for ages. Today's science confirmed this property. All of these are great additions to your eating plan. And guys, these foods will help you for sure if you eat them regularly. Besides their diuretic properties, they also come with several health benefits, as we have seen. But finding ways to help water retention naturally is key to help and protect the kidneys. This is why today I will also show you what vitamins can really help. Now, a question that I always get when I talk about natural diuretics is, my nephrologist gave me a water pill. Should I keep taking it, or should I only use natural diuretics? Now guys, first of all, remember that I will never tell you to disregard your doctor's orders, but focusing more on foods and good habits is a great strategy to reduce your dependence on medications and to protect your kidneys. And there are some good habits that can really help with water retention and that I always recommend, such as exercising regularly, drinking enough water during the day, reducing salt, sugar, and refined carbs intake. These are all great ways to reduce water retention and to help your kidneys and whole body health. And they can really help. You see, prescription diuretics do work, but they also come with unwanted effects. Prescription diuretics or water pills are known to deplete your body of essential vitamins and minerals such as zinc, magnesium, vitamin B1, and vitamin C. Absolutely not something you want. And also consider that these medicines are linked to the triple whammy, a serious cause of kidney damage. OTC diuretics, on the other hand, are something I would recommend avoiding altogether. They are almost always full of caffeine and potassium, and they may be dangerous. So even if they are OTC, only take them if your nephrologist gives them to you. And guys, the foods we have seen today are really great to help you with water retention, but there are vitamins and beverages that can help even more. Let's take a look. What vitamins have detoxifying effects? There are certain vitamins and minerals that you may want to make sure you are not deficient in if you want to reduce water retention. Vitamin C is key when it comes to water retention. Vitamin C has been shown in studies to have diuretic properties by increasing urine output. Make sure you are getting enough of it every day and consider a supplement. Another vitamin you don't want to be deficient in is vitamin B6. Studies are linking increased intake of vitamin B6 with increased urine production. Now, vitamin B6 is mostly found in foods such as avocados, bananas, and pistachios. So if you are limiting these foods because you need to limit potassium, consider a supplement. Now guys, there are a couple of minerals that are even more powerful than these vitamins when it comes to diuretic properties. Magnesium. Magnesium helps regulate water in the body and can have a mild diuretic effect, particularly when an individual has a deficiency. There are good sources of this mineral. We can eat regularly nuts, especially almonds and also whole grains and leafy green vegetables. These can all be regulars on your table. But magnesium deficiency is so common among people with CKD, especially those taking diuretics and in diabetics, that it's recommended to supplement it in most cases. Besides, magnesium supplemented at the same time as vitamin B6 has been studied as a possible treatment for water retention. Just remember to consult with your nephrologist if you want to supplement magnesium. Some people have too high levels of this mineral. But the benefits of magnesium are so significant, I also made a full video about it. It's up here and also down in the description if you want to know more. Now, the other mineral with diuretic properties is potassium. Potassium is a crucial mineral for maintaining fluid balance in the body. It works in contrast to sodium to help regulate fluid balance. Someone with low potassium levels may accumulate sodium and water in the body. And this is why many foods with a diuretic effect are also high in potassium. Now, when it comes to potassium, it's imperative that you keep your levels under control. About 20% of people with CKD have too high potassium and they need to control it. And also about 18% of people with CKD have too low potassium and need more potassium to avoid not just water retention but also kidney damage. So guys, if you want to learn more about this, please watch my video about potassium. It's up here and also down in the description. And what about beverages? Can they really help with detoxification and water retention? Absolutely! Now, the first thing that comes to mind when thinking about beverages with detoxing properties is coffee. Caffeine is a powerful diuretic, no doubt about it. But you see, even if coffee has its benefits, I won't recommend you drink more coffee than you already drink, because it also has side effects and some people react badly to coffee. So maybe drink less coffee, especially avoid it in the afternoon and in the evening. There are, however, a couple of caffeine-free beverages that may really help with water retention. One that I always recommend is hibiscus tea. This beautiful tea you can easily buy at the grocery store has more than just its looks. It comes with several key benefits. First of all, it fights hypertension. A 2015 review of 5 studies published in the Journal of Hypertension determined that drinking this tasty tea can lower pressure by 7.58 over 3.53 millimeters of mercury, which is frankly amazing. A different study from 2012 also noted that hibiscus help increase kidney filtration. And well, if this is not enough for you to consider drinking this tea, also keep in mind that it's a wonderful source of antioxidants, great to protect the kidneys. Another beverage that can really help, hawthorn tea. Now, this one is a bit harder to find. You may have to search for it in your favorite herbal store or on Amazon.com, but the effort will be well rewarded. You see, hawthorn is used to help protect against heart disease and help control high blood pressure and high cholesterol. Both animal and human studies suggest hawthorn increases coronary artery flow, improves circulation, and lowers hypertension. This tea can also reduce fluid buildup and it's often used to protect the heart. Now guys, if you want to learn more about what this can really help, this video up here is for you, and this is all for today. Thank you for watching. God bless you all.